For the past couple of weeks, I've been working on a 2D platformer game, which is for now called Ultimate Platformer. I started off making some better graphics for the game. However, I'm not an artist, so I'm not sure if this really is better. The question of graphics aside, I also worked on making a couple of extra levels. Quick reminder, the player starts off only having their walk and jump ability. As they progress through the levels, more abilities will be unlocked. Right now, the player will unlock a dash and wall slide slash jump ability, but I want to add some more later on. On top of those abilities, I slowly introduced new game mechanics, mainly in the form of obstacles to the player. I added these moving spikes and falling platforms, for example. On top of that, I added fake blocks to the game. Once a player gets close enough, they'll be able to see through these fake blocks. This was very easy to do by simply creating a circular sprite mask, setting the sprite renderers on the fake blocks to visible outside mask, and then parroting the sprite mask to the player. The sprite mask allows me to easily hide some secrets. I'm planning on adding collectibles to the game soon, but I haven't done that yet. I also added the new design to the player, which is heavily inspired by some designs I found online. I also decided that my environment design was trash, so I got some sprites from GameR2D.com, and these made my game look way better in my opinion. I plan on changing the player design again in the near future because it doesn't fit very well with the way the world looks right now. I also added coins to the game. Right now they don't have a real use except for the fact that they are very satisfying to collect. With the coins I can reward the player for taking certain risks as well as for exploring the level. On top of that I can use the coins to nudge the player in a specific direction, especially in a more puzzle-like level. I added a new obstacle to some of the latest levels. This is a falling block of ice that will crush a player if they get hit to it. The sprite of the ice block was from GameArt2D.com and I thought it fit very well with the snow theme. I've also been thinking about a simple story for the game, but I'll talk more about it in the next video. Planning on working more on the game's balancing and fixing bugs in the next week. I also want to add a second enemy type because only one might be a bit too few. The game currently has 16 finished levels, including 4 tutorial ones, but I think I might want to make at least 25 levels because I still have a lot of ideas for the game. Please leave any feedback and thoughts on the game in the comments down below. Also, if you have a name for the game, please leave that in the comments too. If you enjoyed this video, then please consider liking and subscribing to my channel, as it really helps me out. Anyways, I'll see you guys in the next one.